Hey, guest experience team, I want to personally thank you guys for this past Sunday for everything that you guys did. If you guys were here, whether you were serving or you were in the service, you know that this past Sunday, Easter Sunday of 2016, was a Sunday to not forget. It was absolutely amazing to see how God showed up. We saw 750 people join us for worship at Bridgepoint Church, and it was absolutely amazing. I want to talk to you and address a couple of things as we prepare for this coming Sunday. You know, we could take a look at some of the things that happened this past Sunday and say, we as a staff were praying and expecting 500 people and prepared for that. And God said, oh, no, I'm going to shake it up and I'm going to send 750 people your way. And so we are trying in every way to be prepared for that. So there are a couple of changes that I want to address in each of your areas. So bear with me as I go through a couple of things. First of all, parking. We are going to change the parking lot up a little bit. Parking, volunteer parking is going to actually be on the right side of the building, the front part of the parking lot, rather than on the left side. And there's a reason for that. We're going to continue, the parking team is going to continue parking people in the very back of the building, moving them up toward the front. But as we get about halfway up through the parking lot, we are going to actually open up a front entrance on the left-hand side of the building, not the right door, but on the left side of the building as a second entrance so that hopefully people won't have to walk quite as far around the whole building in order to get in. We still want to maintain just a couple of entrances so that we can still have that personal connection. And people aren't going into doors where no one's there to greet them. And so at the front entrance there, and this is for the greeters, we are going to have a welcome banner and have a couple of greeters there at that door. And then at the back of the building in the lobby area, we are going to have our first-time guest area and some greeters there at the door also. So parking lot, volunteer parking on the right side of the building, continuing with everything that you guys did this past Sunday. I know, Ivan, you have a couple of ideas that you're going to be running to and giving and sharing to your parking team. So thank you guys so much for what you did this past Sunday, because I know it was chaotic out there, but you guys knocked it out of the park, as I know that you would. Amy, door greeters, greeters in general, first-time guest greeters. We are, like I said, going to have that front entrance open as soon as the parking lot gets half full. So we'll go ahead and already have a couple of greeters with that. And also in the back, we're going to have our normal door greeters and first-time guest greeters. For first-time guests, we are changing this up a little bit to create more of a flow. And honestly, I'm not even sure why we've never thought about this before. But we are actually in the lobby area with the first-time guests. We are going to join you as far as KidPoint. KidPoint is going to be joining the first-time guest table and have a first-time guest area for KidPoint right next to you. So the parents and children can all get checked in at the same time. And we're using a new check-in system this coming Sunday. And so we're going to kind of go through that. It'll be very simple. That's not going to change anything with our tablets, but just for the check-in. So and Yvonda Whitfield, who's over that, will have that taken care of, and we can talk more about that on Sunday morning. I do want to mention, for all of you that are greeters, I'd like to meet every single person, whether you're in connections, first-time guests, greeters, just door greeters, at 10:15, directly after VIP meeting. I'd like for you guys just to come to the side. We're going to just do a little bit of vision and training for what it looks like to be door greeters and first-time guest greeters in our new facility, because it is a brand new experience. The doors here, the space here is very different than what it is at the Moose Lodge, where we've been for the last 3 years. So we kind of want to go over some of those things. So if you guys could just pull to the side at 10:15, that would be awesome. Also, for you ushers, this is really super important. You guys know that we in KidPoint put a ton of time and energy and resources into making KidPoint the very best children's ministry it can be. And they just do a phenomenal job. And our desire is to really see children connect to Jesus on their level. And that's very difficult for children to do that when Pastor Eric's preaching. Not to say that he's not phenomenal at what he does, but he's not teaching to children. That's not his desire. That's not his focus. And you guys know that. And so we're trying to really encourage parents as much as we can to direct them to check their children into KidPoint. Or to, if they don't feel comfortable with that, to direct them to the family viewing room. And if they still don't feel comfortable with that, then my request is that you guys would be willing to ask any parents who do feel the desire to bring their children into the service to please sit in the back two rows. And that has to come from you as greeters, as you are our front linemen there in the sanctuary for parents to be sitting on the back two rows. Just so that if their child begins to get fussy, that they can stand up and get out of the service easily, go out to the overflow. We will have overflow seating, which will be in our lobby, which will open up directly at 11. We don't know how many people are going to be at church this coming Sunday, but we can't do what we did last Sunday. We broke fire code. Ooh, don't tell anybody. But we can't do that. And so what we're going to need, what we are already preparing for is the sound. There's going to be televisions, two large televisions in the lobby area for people to go and sit at. That's also partly where the ushers come in, and security can help with this too, is once someone exits the sanctuary, our worship center, those doors are going to be closed and you cannot enter back into the sanctuary, into the worship center. It became very distracting this past Sunday, and so we're just going to try and eliminate that distraction as much as we can. It doesn't take much, as you guys all know, for people to be distracted by things, and it always seems to happen that right when the Holy Spirit's really doing something, that's when Satan's like, oh, I'm going to bring up this distraction, and we're just going to try and eliminate that as much as we can. So I just encourage people that once they exit the service, that they can't go back in. And Pastor Eric's going to address that from the stage this Sunday. There's going to be a lot of things that are brand new to the way in which we're going to create a culture here at Bridgepoint that we haven't had before, because we haven't had hard walls or doors going into our sanctuary. So it's going to be a little different. The sanctuary will open at 10:40 and not before then. So we're going to be encouraging people to go into the lobby area, enjoy some coffee from Connection Cafe, that kind of thing. And then next, what I have to share with you guys is, first of all, I do want to thank each and every one of you as volunteers for what you guys do. You do an amazing job, an absolutely amazing job. You know, the church truly isn't the church without the people. A building is just a building. And you guys have heard that now for 5 years from us. A building is just a building. But we are the body. We are the church. And with that being said, I want to thank you guys for what you do. It wouldn't exist without you. But right now, as more and more people are becoming bridge pointers and taking next steps and wanting to get plugged in, that means that we who are on the front lines already doing the work of ministry kind of need to step up our game just a little bit more. And I know that I already asked for you guys to do so much. But right now, I want to ask you guys to give me 2 months. 2 months where you would be willing to work every Sunday to come and serve. I said work, and that's a terrible word. Forgive me for saying that. To serve every other Sunday. And not this Sunday, but the following Sunday, we're going to have something called volunteer service, our VIP service. And if you are serving on a Sunday, we want you to be able to experience worship also. So at 9 a.m., we're going to have our full service. Pastor is going to preach. The band is going to lead us in some incredible worship at 9 a.m., and you guys are going to be able to experience worship together and then go and serve. For me, oftentimes, even as Pastor Eric's wife, I'm not able to be in the service because I'm running around with 1,000 things that I'm doing, and I want to be in worship also. And so this is the way we want to serve you guys. So as you're serving every other Sunday, you can come and worship on a Sunday morning at 9 a.m. together. We can be excited about what God's going to do and have a time of prayer and just really being pumped about what God's going to do in the 11 o'clock service. I do ask that you guys hit your knees praying God to move in a mighty way. I know that He has already done that. And let us let the excitement of what happened last Sunday not dwindle this week, but let us look for anticipation as we look forward to what God is going to do this coming Sunday. I thank you guys so much for everything that you do for the kingdom of God, for Jesus Christ. And thank you for taking 10 minutes to listen to me. I look forward to seeing you guys on Sunday morning at VIP at 10:05. Thanks so much. Bye.